Hi, my name is Melissa Vail. I'm a blogger and digital creator and contributing writer. I don't know why that became such a dirty word, because I mean, it's not like saying someone's a socialite or something, which, you know, doesn't imply that someone does anything. I mean, if you are an influencer, you are influencing people. So I'm not really sure how it got this connotation of bad things, but I mean, it is part of what I do. I mean, I am influencing people, whether it's to, you know, purchase something or to think about something a little bit differently, or, you know, something to do with your day. So, I mean, I don't think it's a bad word, but at the same time, you know, I'm hesitant to use it sometimes, but, you know, it is what it is, but I don't really think it's a bad word per se. I've been in fashion in some way or another for a while, and I used to cover events and different, you know, fashion events, beauty events, you know, charity events for more, traditional digital media in a way, whether it's the Huffington Post and other outlets like that. And I mean, Instagram started what, like 2010 or 2012?
Yeah.
I wasn't on it then. So we, you know, that's a major way of promoting something now, obviously, instead of just like, well, what publication are you from? It's, you know, well, what's your handle? And, you know, posting things on your Instagram stories, especially. And if you have like, you know, 10, 20,000 people viewing it, I mean, that's a huge deal. And then it's a lot of people doing, you know, that, and then it adds up to, you know, more than what it was before. So I mean, it just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. Yeah. I was working in real estate. I mean, I still do, actually. Don't quit your day job, people. And we had a 2-week training class, and we had two social media classes, and even the classes that were about other things that weren't about social media, it was always plugged, you know, well, of course you should be plugging this on your social media, right? And so I was really in earnest using my Instagram, mainly some of it Facebook, to promote my properties, promote other properties I've seen, open houses, and then just like, you know, things I've seen, like taking a picture of this building, or, you know, this like marble or something, and just posting it out there. And what happened, and it was doing well, and I was engaging, and a lot of real estate people were interested in, you know, other people from New York and other places and stuff. And what happened was that usually my husband would take pictures of me on my way to a showing. They were often on Sunday at the time, so I would hashtag Sunday showings. And it was with my iPhone 6, very questionable quality pictures, and it would be in my OOTD, my outfit of the day. And all my posts were doing well, but those did by far the best of any of my posts in terms of engagement, in terms of bringing me more followers. Like, that's where I would see a lot of my follower growth. And, you know, then I would engage back and forth with these fashion accounts, and they would follow me and engage, and I'd get to know them, and they were from all different parts of the world. And, you know, I sat down with myself, you know, after a couple months of this, and, you know, you have goals in life, right? And obviously I want to be a really successful real estate agent, I want to be a top real estate agent, blah, blah, blah. But then you see something else kind of coming, you know, from another direction, and you can't just have blinders on. You have to be open to like other things that happen, which is why I never like to be too rigid in my goals, because you just never know what life is going to bring you. And I mean, it still really surprises me that in such an oversaturated market, you know, you think there are so many fashion bloggers. Why are people interested in my outfits when I'm showing these gorgeous properties? Not that they weren't interested in that, but why are they even more interested in this? Do you know what I'm saying? And it still blows my mind why, but I guess there's just an insatiable demand for it out there, no matter what you say. And so I really had to sit down with myself and say, I've got to give this a good old college try, because, you know, I'd be cheating myself if I didn't, you know, like the signals were there, and I really had to give it a go. You know, imagine if I actually put some effort into it, the quality of the photography, you know, think out my messaging and my branding, and, you know, make it a professional thing. So that's what I did. And I still work in real estate, which is, you know, is good. And, you know, obviously it's always good to do something else. But also because it informs my brand a bit. It informs, you know, who I want to partner with, like how I want to message particular posts and things like that. So it's good. It's kind of a guide for me, which I like. Melissa D. Vail is my Instagram handle, and my blog is themelissavail.com. Hi, my name is Melissa Vail, and you've just been buzzed.